What's up, guys? Barry Gaming here, back with some more Idle Heroes news for February 5th, 2022. So, we do, of course, have this second week of Chinese New Year. You guys have probably already figured out, but we need to look forward to Valentine's Day, which is coming up right around the corner. So, we're going to take a look at the event preview that we have so far. We're going to compare it to previous year's events. So we're going to see what we kind of need to save for Valentine's Day, if anything. So, hopefully, you guys enjoy this one. Make sure you guys hit that subscribe button. Let's jump right into it. So starting off, let's jump to the in-game event preview. We've talked about this previously, but of course we have the Prophet Summoning Prize event. Now this is a really, really, really good Prophet Summoning event because it has potentially undeniably... We could argue that she is by far the best non-light and dark or transcendence hero in the game. I guess the normal four factions. You could argue maybe Rogan's up there, but Rogan doesn't do everything that Eloise can do for an account that's not in the extreme endgame. If you're not in the extreme endgame, you definitely want to go after this hero. Being that there is a bonus event coming along with this Prophet Summoning event, this might be the time to finally unleash your four loops, the 320 Prophet Orbs you've been saving up. I'm really hoping there's a good pay-to-win artifact reward during this Valentine's event tied to your Prophet Summoning, because this could be very, very good. Talking about very good, everything on this event is very good so far. If you have been saving up your Universal Crystals, so of course, as you guys know, you should be saving them up. How many are we up to? We might have actually spent them 880. You want to just keep saving up to about 1,000 to 1,100 of them. For events like this, where the Mysterious Artifact Selection Chest is actually the reward. Now, this has everything in it besides Melodic Strings. It even has the Snow Hearts for those PvPers out there looking to get those end-game strategies going. But this is by far one of the best campaign events to go for because it has a chest. It gives variety, whatever you need. You can save it. You can buy it and save it for later until you can actually decide what you want to use it on. Very, very good. So it usually takes about 1,000 to 1,200 of those crystals, because you should get somewhere in the ballpark of 2,400 to 2,600 of the campaign currency, so long as you're logging in. I think it's like every 12 hours for the campaign loot. You don't have to necessarily claim it. You just have to go into it so you can see it, and then it'll keep refreshing and adding up by far. So we already have one amazing event next week. We got two amazing events next week. Well, let's just top that off with a third amazing regular event in Heroic Miracle giving a carry copy. Again, undeniably probably one of the best heroes you could potentially get from Heroic Miracle, even if you've already built your carry. Things like Star Expedition want you to have additional five-star... You can never have enough carries. Like, let's just be honest. You can build a carry on any account past like the mid game and it's probably fine. You can have five star carries, throw them into Guild Wars, throw them into IDA teams. Just such a cool, versatile hero. Level them up to 100, slap some gear on them. They're gonna do good for you. And then finally, we get to the main topic here, Valentine's Day. So event number one, Confession Balloons. Bunnies come with balloons on, bunnies? Okay, on the Valentine's Day. Send items to bunnies for lucky rewards with a chance to get heroes. That's a little interesting. Event number two, Love at First Sight. Spend Valentine's Day with Valentino and Eloise. Increase affection for unexpected surprises. Who do you want to spend Valentine's Day with? Now, event number two sounds a lot like the event we just had, and we've had quite a bit, where you have two different columns of rewards for each hero. Usually the left side takes less, but you get like a pay to win artifact at the bottom. I'm really, really hoping that right there is tied to using your Prophet Orb loops, because we could really use a really good pay to win artifact. Maybe it'll even have Melodic Strings. That would be crazy if they already gave Melodic Strings away for Prophet Orb. Fingers crossed. And then lastly, the right side of the column is typically more the pay to win side, where you can get multiple Melodic Strings or something like that. So it is what it is. And then event number three, Romantic Letters. Use the Magic Memory Crayon to help you recall those sweet moments recorded in Romantic Letters. So this is kind of interesting. And I'd be surprised if one of these doesn't have something that we're about to talk about here in a second, and that is a matching system. There's a couple things that past Valentine's Day events have had. Last year's was an exception because Valentine's Day was part of the two-week Chinese New Year event, so we didn't really get like a dedicated Valentine's Day event, which felt bad. But I want to jump back to 2020 and show you guys what 2020 was about, because it was pretty interesting. So last year we had this matching event, or I think we might have had one last year, but this was mainly 2 years ago and previous years. There was like a matchmaking system where by matching certain heroes that you had unlocked, just the 5-star version, you basically got the rewards. You got like a low tier pay to win artifact. You got a brand new skin for a hero that might not be the most up to date and useful, but is probably still one of the best skins in the game, in my opinion. You got some light and dark combos here, and you have some four. So he had like a faction combination for each one of them, except this one, which was really weird that it was like mixture of the two, but hey, whatever. And then once you paired them all off, you got the Golden Crown, which at the time was like the brand new artifact. It was really, really good. It was interesting. I forget what this actually had to do with up here. Maybe that's what it was. You got the currencies and you had to pick them and you could get hero copies. That could be what the one event we're talking about getting hero copies about. So if you were to go ahead and like, you know, you picked an Oberon copy on the men's side and then a Heart Watcher, that gave you the bonus rewards. That's what it was. Sorry about that. So you kind of pick what you wanted. If you only wanted the Lucky Candy Bar, you would just pick the Nakia and the Kathuga and be done with it. But you could get a crown, which at the time was the premium artifact. So chances are there's probably a good chance we're going to get Melodic Strings somewhere in this event. There were some bonus packages with, you know, the lower tier loot and then the more pay to win loot for the event. You could also turn the lower tier loot into the pay to win event. I think it was like these letters right here that you gave to these tiers. I can't remember exactly. It's been 2 years since, so it's kind of rough in my memory. But you can get some other cool loot like that. Of course, you got the basic reward from the loot for Wishing Fountain that time, which was very interesting for such a big event. It was on Wishing Fountain. It was pretty solid. This was one of those that it was definitely worth saving your wishing coins for. This time we're using Profit Orb, so hopefully it pays off. And then lastly, we had two awesome looking skins. So I'm definitely guessing we're gonna get one or two new skins this week coming up for Valentine's Day as well. So let me know what you guys think. If my memory serves me correctly, the past couple Valentine's Days, you didn't really even need to save up gems for them. It was more or less saving up those Profit Orbs. So this is like one of those big events where I hope you've been listening and saving up four loops of Profit Orbs, because I really do think this is going to be the one that really, really pays off and gets you maybe the newest pay to win artifact. These Melodic Strings is very, very strong. So hopefully you guys know this one. Make sure you guys hit that subscribe button. I'll see you guys next time.